Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Dante Brooks clubbing anything he wanted, but he wanted to be a bad man. Today, we're going to talk about this. Not just the Dante Brooks case, but we have to go back to culture and mindset. You see, when you talk about culture, such a powerful word, the Cambridge Dictionary defines it as the way of life, especially the general customs and beliefs of a particular group of people at a particular time. Every nation, every city, every community of a culture. Then you may talk about acidic culture. I'm going to tell you why youths like Dante Brooks end up behind jail bars or end up in an early grave. But before we do that, I want to read the press release about the trial. Just to give you an idea as to how Dante Brooks ended up in this situation. Now, just in case you're somebody who is not familiar with popular culture, Dante Brooks is the son of popular entertainer Mavado. Right. Now, let me just read directly from the press release. I'm going to go to the part where it says evidence led during trial. You can Google this and see it for yourself. Anyway, it says, and I quote, "During the 12-day trial, the prosecution presented evidence from 14 witnesses, 14. The prosecution led evidence based on a direct eyewitness testimony of the father of the deceased. So the victim, right, a young man by the name of Lorenzo Thomas, him father or the star witness. As in, his father was there and see what go down. Let me carry on. The evidence was that on the day before the incident, the eyewitness received word that his son was going to be killed and made arrangements for his son to stay elsewhere. He later had a brief altercation with the accused Brooks. So basically, the father get tipped off, because you know it got ready. When people are going to do things, man start talk, we're going to do this to him, somebody here, and tip it off. Tell us, hey, you know, say, I'm going to come for you, I'm going to do this to you, now. This give me flashback of the Charmaine Rattray case. People also went to her and said, listen, I'm going to come for you, know. Right. So this father got tipped off, and as it says, he was trying to make arrangement, but this is the day before. Right. It's very rare people have multiple places where them can just go left and go stay, right? So he's probably thinking, all right, can I make two calls and maybe by a weekend, the very next day, them turn up. I carry on. Later that night, the eyewitness visited his son to give him some money for food, and then he returned home. The eyewitness passed both persons along the road, including the accused men, before entering his yard. He went into his yard and later saw his son arrive at home. Right, so the father reached home before the son. The eyewitness for a couple hours observed both accused men and other persons standing near his fence, which he pointed out to his son. So the father can see Dante Brooks and Hines, who is the next person who got found guilty with him, right, and other man. A linger on. This is after him here, say, they will come do him some things. Carry on. The eyewitness and his son then retired to their individual beds. The eyewitness was sitting on his bed and his son was lying on his bed in his room. Shortly after, at about 3:30 a.m., the eyewitness heard when the door to his son's bedroom was kicked off. He heard the shot. His son dropped on the ground and hold him chest. Man. The eyewitness saying he saw both accused men, again that's Dante Brooks and Hines, and two other persons in his son's room. So that's four men in there. Man. Four of them in there. I don't know if they're two. I don't know what to them. If them deceased already or whatever, or them just never get catch, I don't know, but four of them go in there. He heard the accused Hines asked if he, the eyewitness, was to be killed and heard another person and the accused Brooks say, no, him not for dead. This is very important. So them done, wet up the sun already. And now Hines asks Dante Brooks, right, and somebody else, if the father is dead too. That means Dante Brooks, this little boy, was leader of the operation to the point where the actual youth who do the messy work, I turn around and I ask him if he's dead too. How can a little boy be leading big man Panem Absa? You know why? Because he was moving on the strength and the clout of being Movado's son. That's why big man bigger than him, if you turn on to him and ask him an next man question if he's dead. And the man the bigger man for him. We're getting to all of that. The eyewitness saw the accused Brooks pass a cutlass to one of the persons in the room, and then in bracket it says not before the court. So that person, right, for some reason or another, he's not a part of the trial. Right. But then this person tried to take off the head of the deceased. That's Lorenzo Thomas. The person then say the cutlass too dull. That same person then emptied him gun in the youth head. Empty it. So he tried to take off the youth head, but the cutlass not sharp enough. So instead them decide fit gruesome scenes. He goes on to state, this same person then requested the gas, poured some on the deceased, dashed some on the house, set it on fire. The man then ran out of the house. The father escaped through a back door. His son was born up beyond recognition. Only after the Jamaica Fire Brigade came and put out the fire and put out the, I saw them could have still the remains. He goes on to state, the prosecution was conducted by two prosecutors from after the DPP, right, and Mr. Brooks, which is Dante Brooks, was represented by Peter Champagne, QC, right, Mr. Asbestina Smith and Mr. Mika Harris. Big liar, big money liar. The money have enough. Not one, not two, but three liar. Guess what? I could have 300 liar. The boy never stand a chance in a court. Dante Brooks never stood a chance in a court. When I heard who the witness was before all this even reached court, Mr. the father, he was finished. Because due to the fact that I'm son that happened to, he was going to see this trial all the way through. Forget justice for him, son. Instead of going for 2-3 or 300 lawyer, them should have plead guilty and cop out and stand before the judge and tell the judge, to your honor, Dante Brooks is a young man. He make a mistake, and even though he should pay for this mistake, don't end him life, don't end him future. Please be lenient in the sentencing. And due to the fact that he plead guilty, and it's probably his first offense, he won't look upon the time when I go look upon now. Because Dante Brooks is now 18, so he will get big man sentence. But instead, go for 1, 2, 3, big liar, QC. Peter Champagne, QC. No mean nothing in front of a solid witness. That no mean, it could be QD, QE, QP, it means nothing in the face of a solid witness. When man bust case, is because either the witness don't turn up or the witness is shaky. In the face of a solid witness, you are finished. Okay, carry on. Just they wanted to know why the young man was before the courts, but they didn't start. But they didn't start work yet. I whoop and have a cup of coffee now and on the TRW because I'm about to go in because this is a sad case. You know why this is a sad case? Wasted potential. Dante Brooks could have been anything he wanted, but he wanted to be a bad man. You know why he wanted to be a bad man? Because of culture and mindset. See, your favorite simpleton tell you, say, all the youths them need is just money. If youths have money, badness would stop. Because if they not, it's called them not the money, why the youth them was gone? And because the youth them poor, why the youth them was gone? Poverty is what drives Jamaica's high murder rate. A theory you heard me dismissed time and time again with more than enough facts. Anybody who have two brain cells rubbed together surely can't believe that in a 2021. Culture and mindset. How a youth who have every opportunity a youth can have end up in a situation like this? I'll tell you why. Because even though Dante Brooks could have gone on to become a neurosurgeon, he wanted to be a bad man. Because in his eyes, a bad man is of higher value and gets more respect than said neurosurgeon. He could have gone on to become a teacher, an engineer, a lecturer. He could have done anything he wanted to do. Anything he wanted, his father could have paid feed for him. Sky is the limit. What he wanted to run the place. He didn't want to run the company. He wanted to run the place. He wanted to run the ends. That's culture. Dante Brooks grew up and see who get the hype, who get the respect. Dante Brooks, what they doing a cast of a piece and see the ratings we call upon them and they get. That's who I want to be. Forget about all this nerd business. Nothing about engineer, that's nerd business. What? Neurosurgeon, that's nerd business. Teacher, that's nerd business. What? Architect, that's nerd business. Stop wasting my time. Wanna run ends. Wanna run off corner. That's culture driving that. And highly paid people with 10, 15 letters of any of them name compound the TV and tell them, say, a poverty drive youths to go in a badness. But them can't explain why Malawi and Benin, right, Sierra Leone, and countries where people don't even have 2 stone for up together have lower murder rate than even the United States and the United Kingdom and France and many European countries. They can't tell you that. Because they know it's rubbish. But they use that because when they use the poverty excuse, it says to the people, we not have to change. Because Jamaicans can say, well, I know my fault the youth them poor, so me not have to do nothing. That way we never ever address the culture and more youth end up on the conveyor belt of death and destruction. You can't believe this happened to the youth. Oh, Dante Brooks, if you know that jail was with youth, who never get 1% of the opportunities that him get. Right. And the enablers them, but they own him. Let me tell you, man. Listen, don't be surprised if this video go on for 3 hours. I'm annoyed and I don't even know the youth. If you see how it end. Right. Every time I look upon this youth, I don't know him personally, but every picture I ever see of Dante Brooks, the youth have a menacing aura. Look at him. Every picture I see of this youth, people know in real life. I'm like, yo, find a picture, yeah. Everybody said the same thing. No little boy enough have them kind of aura, yeah. No little boy enough have them eyes there. Eh? Why that youth have that eyes? People around him to see them eyes there. Eh? Before him even do what him do. Nobody around him to see that. From this youth is a little school as him have the same look what him have now. Dante Brooks, father, built mansion in the sky. And the youth want their own a cassava piece. In an argumented man, a push badness from a cassava piece. It's culture. When people tell you, say, oh, if the youth say, let's get more money, look where money do mob here. Make mob here people tell you about money. When youth them start get rich off of scamming and drugs, what them do? Every man go start buy up them guns and ammunition and stockpile, and who did have scores was settle it. The richer the youth them get, the more violent them get. The more man are dead. And I have nothing to do with no money. Jamaican youth aspire to be gunman. How that makes sense? In almost every other culture in the world, gunmen are seen as degenerates. Nobody even want to stand next to them people. This one in Jamaica, 87 octanes, 90 octanes. We already know about 116, so them get for them rating. But 87, even your standard run of the mill, bottom of the barrel, 87 octanes, have more respect than a teacher. Come on, hit that dislike button. Hit that dislike button and subscribe and go on where I go. I'm working here. I said in Jamaica, an LIQ can barely read, can't put two words together, 87, get more respect in our society than a teacher, a doctor, a policeman, an engineer. Hell, you could have cured our cancer. You could have cured the big C tomorrow. And a regular run-of-the-mill 87 who have 3-4 body, pan him name, we'll have more man who won't be like him and more woman who won't be with him. Come on, hit that dislike button. Because your favorite woke activist, I'm not going to tell you this. I'm going to tell you all the youths to need us more money. Give the youths them more money. Then you see crime job. Rubbish. Complete rubbish. Jamaican youths aspire to be dons. This is why. As soon as your favorite entertain a boss, all if him was a normal youth. As in boss, 5, 10, 15, 20, 87 the back of him. Then he say, name get called over yasso. Then name get called over yasso. Jamaican youths hustle backwards. They make money and then go in a crime. That's hustling backwards. That's the dumbest thing ever. Old time man, do crime, forget money. Jamaican youth get money and then go do crime. Man get criminal record after I'm rich. Come on, hit that dislike button. I'm working here. Your favorite woke TV snag a tell you this. Your favorite platform where you give that low frequency nonsense, make you feel good now, go tell you this. Woman figure rich and at them time they get criminal record after you're rich. When you was a poor youth on the corner, police don't know your name. And then you go turn scammer and get 100 million. And now all of a sudden, you're in a station every minute. The youths them are also backwards. Youths them want to be done. They want to run out of place. They see the respect. We're kerosene. The gunman. Them see the respect of other man, the gunman. Them hear people talk about them. Them hear anything and sing about them. That's who they want to be. They don't want to be no nerd astrophysicist. That's a nerd. And a fool to say I tell them about architect, come here do that. No girl don't want to argue. That's stupid. That's a nerd. What? Learn off him. Mix matter. You mean set up in a sun? He must be mad. A joke thing that. No depend on that. You them want to be dance. Come on, run, please. Let me tell you something. The reason why enough gangs are completely implode is because some youth have to take talk from a bigger man to get gun. You see, any certain youth get the money if you can buy them own a gun? Come on, man. Maybe people only there. Who are probably the best for talk about this? Norwood, Salt Spring, only the Glen Devon, Cambridge people come talk now. Talk about the reason why it is almost impossible for no one done. Bring Moby under control. You know why? Because every youth is almost, them have their own money and they go build their own gun and their own local gang. You can't tell them nothing. Money? All the youths them need money? That's an LIQ argument. They wouldn't. I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised. You know, Jamaica is a place where any argument will require people to do any kind of real thinking is quickly dismissed. So just throwing out the poverty. And then in the argument, it works. I understand why people push it, it works. All those lazy educators and lazy academics who, you know, just want to come play a TV screen and get a 1-4 and just come out, don't worry, it's poverty. If you send your money and crime and a job, no. The culture have to change first. A culture where wrong is elevated and right is downgraded. A culture where if you don't support certain foolishness, if you don't support certain slackness, people actually cost you. A culture where degeneracy is the order of the day. I could stay upon the word, man, culture. When you see some group of people head in a certain direction, and the next group of people head in another direction, one might have prosper, and one appear across it. The simple thing to do is to say, well, that culture for yourself, but this group of people have money. That group of people, none of money. People are looking on the fact that it's the culture that allows and sets the conditions for those people have the money. And it's the culture that sets the conditions to these people for yourself don't have the money. It is culture where a young girl from an ornate garden or a Tivoli garden, a young girl from a Norwood or a Glen Devon, when she reach a certain age, when she barely start to develop as a woman, she start come under pressure for have pitney from her neighbors. You're 17, you're 18, you're not breed yet. It is culture that pushes young men to turn father before them even ready. It is culture that make young men feel safe. To be somebody, they might fear about gun. That's culture. It is culture why Mr. Chin Pitney feels that him need for going to the supermarket business and the wholesale business. He's carrying on a culture. When if people really listen to me. It is culture why children from one area look up to and aspire to be entrepreneurs and to be going the medicine field and going the engineering field. It is culture because in their world, that's who they're the top of society and that's who they want to be, because at the end of the day, everybody want to be admired and adored and everybody want to have people show them respect and people want validation. So in this culture, in this area, in this community, in this country, people say, them man ya, they are the top, them man ya get the respect. So the children them aspire to be them man ya. But in this culture, where gunman, right, 87, 90 acting, are at the top of society, get the most respect, get the most adoration, get the most woman, then the next generation aspire to be that. Young Jamaican athletes, see Jamaican runners excel in sprinting, so every Jamaican athlete, every young runner want to be a sprinter. Jamaican athletes don't aspire to be marathon runners because we have no culture of marathon running. Youths them want to run the 100 and the 200 and the 400. 800 are the most them in Wango. Ask every little youth, they want to be Usain, they want to be Shelly. That's the culture. If we suddenly start winning marathons and 10,000 miles at the Olympics, you're going to see a bag of school youths start to aspire to be 10,000 meter runners. Culture. It's feeling the money. It's a lazy argument. Now, let me just say this. People that message me and tell me, say, well, you don't have to leave my father because my father did the best he could have do and he gave the youth everything he could have possibly want. I said it before. You know, for many Jamaicans, as long as you provide the material things, what else you want me to do? This, you know, hey, give him lunch money, I gave him school book and bag on him. School fee was paid, so nothing to do with me. I really hope that's not the angle Mavado look at it from, and I doubt that's the angle Mavado look at it from. Because Mavado, like most men, sharing the success of them children and also their failures. Because if Dante Brooks did come up with the formula, but cure the big C, Mavado would be sticking out his chest and saying, that's my boy. And he would be sharing in this success. So now that this happened to the boy, as a father, it is only natural that you also share in the failure. But I have to put as a disclaimer, that's just my perspective. That's just how me look upon life. Pitney grew up, come turn, as me say, come cure big C. Me a share your best beliefs, and me all if me never spend one day in the lab with that child, you can't tell me say my parenting now have something to do with it. Me a share that's my success, and if people grow up, come to most wanted, I end up behind bars or police kill him off. Then I'm also sharing in the failure, and I'm also looking into myself, and I be asking myself, maybe me never do this. Maybe I'm sure of this. Maybe I never do enough of this. But that's just my perspective. So I'm just going to add a disclaimer there. I don't know how my father looks upon life. But based on many of the messages I've been receiving, I know how enough people look upon life. And the attitude is, nothing for me, give lunch money, nothing for me. But I'm telling you, as a man, I'd be sharing in the field. I'd be checking myself. Even though I never send him go bust no gun, never give him no gun, you know, tell him to kill nobody, but I'd be looking into myself. But that's just me. I told you my views on leadership already. If I'm a platoon commander and the men in my platoon get killed, that fall upon my shoulder, even though I don't kill them. No matter how good we plan the ops, if they die, that falls on my shoulder as a leader, but that's just my outlook on life. I don't know how people look on life. This is a sad case. You know what we should be hearing? We should be hearing about. We should be looking at a 3, 4, 5 store building somewhere on Canton Spring Road, proudly displaying the family name, showing off the headquarters of the Brooks Empire. This boy should be inheriting his father's legacy and building Pantapide. Instead, he embraced himself to go sit down in a workhouse for a very long time. What a sad case. And again, we can't forget somebody lost their life here. Lorenzo Thomas, I'm sure for him father now sitting and I think to himself, this is a sad father, I think to himself, yeah, good riddance. That's what Lorenzo Thomas' father would be thinking. So when we say this is a sad case, I'm looking at it from the perspective of another black youth gone behind bars, who had the opportunities to make something of himself and not just better his own life but his community. Instead, he's now branded as a murderer. How many more youths have to go up on the conveyor belt before Jamaican people accept reality? That the culture and the mindset we have as a people is producing young men who are attracted to degenerate behavior. That the way we are doing things, something is wrong here. But the people with the biggest voice and the biggest following continue, because no matter what we say right now, any popular entertainer can come out and say the opposite, even though, and even if it's complete rubbish, the facts are feeling biased bigger than mine, that's what the masses will work with. The culture that spawned a Dante Brooks will exist after Dante Brooks gone in a workhouse. When I talk about the conveyor belt, and let me tell you, no found entertainer something. See, no found entertainers don't realize that when the fans, when the so-called fans, don't really care about them or love them. I tell you no why. You see, if when the fans did love them and love them pity them, they may see them do certain things and touch them on their shoulder and say, no, what you do? No, sir, you have too much opportunities for this. Look at this. Who do you want you to near me? When them a clean, new, illegal gun in this job, if them did love you and love your pitney, they may say, no, sir, you can't come here, sir. Move from right there, sir. You have too much opportunity. Move from right there, sir. This is not for you. When them a pass around chalice and you pitney them straight with them on, then they love you and care about you, they want to pass it to him. You're 16 at school left there. Move from right there. So when you grow up and turn money, you can't burn all the chalice you want. But right now, move from right there, so you're a picnic. You see them sit down on the corner sharing the clout. You know some of other Sundays, yeah, man. Now found out the fans them leaving that straight because I'm going to tell you something about them, the so called fans them. You know, realize that the biggest support them gear when time on the sing their foolishness. When you sing beer acidic nonsense to feed the chaos that resides inside of your fandom, at them time they only get the most support. When you realize that your fake fans them don't even buy your album them. I've seen your sales. I've seen every time Jamaican dancehall artists put out albums, I'm always looking at the sales. Because numbers don't lie. You can hype up yourself all you want and call yourself this and give yourself any nickname you want, give yourself. Numbers don't lie. And the biggest dancehall artist in Jamaica can't outsell a dead man. A man is dead from what kill feel like your biggest the artist don't hype up, but the biggest thing in the world and the world can't outsell a dead man. Jamaican artists struggle for sale 2,000 copies. Your fans have every excuse why they can't spend $9.99 to buy your album. But if you tell them to go buy a bleaching cream, it costs $200,000, then you find it. If you tell them to buy one shoes, it costs $1,000,000, then you buy it. If you tell them to buy one phone, anything you hype up, anything the biggest, anything that they hype up, them fans will buy it. Except them album. Come on, hit that dislike button. Bunch of fake fans, stick me in a sooner. Frauds. I love my artist. You never support him yet though. Only reason you listen to his media album is because it's free on Spotify. If you have a pay fee, you won't listen to nothing. Right, but you spend your money to Clarks, and you give your money to Gucci, you give your money to Louis Vuitton, you give your money to BMW, you will give your money to Samsung, you give your money to Apple, but you won't spend $9.99 on your so-called artist where you claim to your door. Fraud. Go on, hit this like one. That's all you can do. Fraud. Your fans don't care about you. They just love the acidity where you give them. Start singing about peace and love and see how quick them switch by you. Stop singing about skin out and this and see how quick them switch by you. Come on. You know I'm right. That's why you can't switch. And if you want to switch, because none of these entertainers, when they meet them personally, let me tell you, sir, to be honest, they want to make some of them type of music, yeah. Tell the truth. They want to make this type of music, because, but at least the people they want. Ask them, don't ask me. I'm just a YouTuber, I'm just make up things to get views. I'm bad mind, scam, and bad mind artist. So ask if you're in it. Let me tell you, they want to sing about them things, because right now, I'm a big man, and they want my people. Let me tell you. I've met many entertainers in real life, them tell you straight up. You're acidic fans. Feed into an acidic culture. What a case. Dante Brooks could have been anything he wanted to be. But he wanted to be a bad man. How many more Dante Brooks will there be? How many more youths have to go to an early grave? Or end up behind bars? For the people them accept reality. Stop put youths on the conveyor belt. Is it that we can't do it or we don't want to do it? So which one is it? Prevent these youths, even when they will get the opportunity, from end up in a them situation. Either we can't do it or we don't want to do it. Which is it? As me say, I'm disappointed and I don't even know the youth. I don't know the Dante Brooks, I'm disappointed. Jamaica is a place where everybody come here, come get rich and prosperous. Man left from all corners of the world, and then the left as no rich man neither. Enough of them left us, so enough people left them country. As poor man and come to Jamaica, come to big shot. And youths who live in a Jamaica. Young black boys who have the opportunity, who have the money, who have access to the capital, who can go get for them wholesale, who can go build for them supermarket. They have a murder charge. It's like, oh no, me can't get my head around it. But you hear me say it many times, you can't plant mango seed and expect apple tree to grow. The boy is reaping the seeds in where he sow. I'm just disappointed that a young man who defy the odds, defy the statistics, him and him father defied the odds, come into newfound wealth, and instead of building and building and building and building and the Brooks name being equivalent to the Mahfood name or the Stewart name or something like that in 2-3 generation, instead you would sit on a workhorse. Him father hasn't been back in Jamaica for how long? Police him and question him. Him father built a lovely house. I remember when they used to post the video of them, right, showing how he said to myself, well done, Mavado, from the gully side to the hillside, or something like that. I think that's what he said, from the gully side to the hilltop. Stunning property, can't sleep at night. That foreigner now come back. Extraordinary. The only hope, say, other youths see this and learn from it. But let me use the word hope, because it don't look like anybody I learn. As me say, I'm disappointed I'm in a new him. Young youth. Do you think Dante Brooks was surrounded by people on the ends who like give him no good advice? No, for them little licky wanga got Monday. Say little boy come around them. And through little boy have clout, have been entertain a son. Sit down and encourage. Sit down and entertain little boy and badness. I walk back a little boy through little boy father a superstar. Not for these so-called grown men in Jamaica, and if you check on yourself, bunch of groupies. And shall run the Dante Brooks and him a little boy and a company ends. Where you a go? Because if you never have company, you can't buy it out company pan ends. He had company. But because you know, could have some money and him can buy this and buy that. Father back, big man, man bigger than Dante Brooks, I look to him and ask him, boy, if they kill father too. Like a teenager. Boy, they even don't grow yet. You know, too long start growing that arm. Look youth. Turn on and seek permission. What's the next step, boss? too many weak and spineless men in Jamaica. So the youths them can't even grow. The youths them can't grow up for much because the people in my head them ain't much either. But never know how to talk about that. But like one like said, the youths them surrounded by these amazing role models and astray, which amazing role models. Run with the little boy. A long time my companions and I try each up himself in a badness. Move from right here, sir. Go take your book. Go on, go become a nerd. That's what you should aspire to be. Me telling all the time, say, nerd is the way to go. The world is run by nerds. The world is not run by an 87 octanes. Or a 90 or even a 160. And nerds run the world. Check the Forbes list. Check the man name who have the ability. You look on the President of the United States. Look on the last President of the United States. When you see who his biggest rivals were? Nerds. Man, they could have silenced him. The President had him pick him off a Twitter and block a call. Nerds. But no one run ends. No one man run in our knees. My boss. My general. My general, you're done. You're my boss. That's success, you know. That's culture. As me say, I'm disappointed and I don't know the youth. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself, PIA, you don't know, no life, Vulture squad, do what vultures do, bless.